Let's look at it. Let's see. There we go. Down the music a bit. There we go. Here's the problem with itg. It strings a bit. At least on a with this big nozzle and stuff, it very quickly strings quite a lot. It's probably my fault too, not just the PETG's fault. Should probably not be so aggressive with high extrusion, and I think also I have a bit of a higher temperature on this. Cut my head off. There we go. I probably have a bit of a high extrusion temperature too on this setting, so it does usually need a tiny bit of cleanup. Have my knife isn't here at all. Oh, okay. Anyway. There we go. That's how we modeled it. Let's see if the iPhone fits. Oh, it's a bit tight. Yeah, that's too tight. That's tight enough for me to be a bit scared. So we need... Maybe we should just make both the gap there that we talked about. Should probably extend that a bit. And I am very interested in how well this stuff will hold up, if it will just drop down, because it could just, like you see here, it could just slide. That's a possibility, that there's not enough force, so it will just slide. Or if there is enough force, like that, and it doesn't. But yeah, exactly. There you go. I'm scared this won't be enough. So then what I was thinking was to curve these guys. And this is too much given it. So we need to make this part thicker. Need more space here. The height of it, I think the height is more than okay, but it's leaning too much probably. That's scary. Feels like I actually might break the phone doing that. Let's see. Let's make some quick changes and start another print. Well, yeah. Let's do that. It only takes 18 minutes per print, so we might as well do some refining. So our first observation is that there, that is a tiny bit too narrow. So the opening there should probably be a bit wider. This should be thicker, this part, because it flexes too much. I'm not sure the actual grip rods need to be any bigger. They feel, well, not strong, but they don't feel like they'll break under this pressure. See. Drink my down a time. What? There we go. Okay. So let's do the changes we talked about here. The first thing was this. Let's make that 7.5 millimeters. And I think that'll be enough, honestly. It's not a lot. We don't need to change a lot there for it to be big enough. Although, I would like to... If this is going to be used on my girlfriend's phone too, I think it needs to be wider down here. Let's change... See, what was it? The depth here. It's 9 millimeters. Let's make it 10 and see. Yeah, so it's stretched. But that should still be 7.5. Maybe 8 would be better. But yeah, let's make it 8. Because the big nozzle also introduces a bit of inaccuracy. So let's try 8. And then if it is too big, we'll just make another one. And then I think they're long enough. And honestly, this doesn't really scare me too much, the width of it. No, Siri, there's nothing you can help. The width of it doesn't really scare me. Oh, there it cracked. Luckily, the phone was cracked before, but it just propagated the crack that it was. So this is too thin. Well, too small here. But yeah, so I'm not really scared of the width of it. I think it's actually wide enough for at least for the tests. So let's just keep it that wide, but this thing needs to be thicker. That times 2. Something like that. Oh, of course, and then all the fillets crashed. Okay, come on. Your thing. Do this. Here we go. You're okay. Come on, come back. Where is it failing now? Okay. I don't care about that. Let's delete that. Or that. But we need to add some filleting here. Let's see. 1 millimeter. Now all of that basically can have a 1 millimeter. Nope. Won't do. Okay, so it doesn't really like that. Okay, not the most important one, but it's nice to have. Won't be very pretty, but let's be honest, it isn't not very pretty anyway, so that's twice as thick now. That should be okay. This is wider, so it shouldn't crack any more phones. And then the question is, should we try to extend it, like, in between here? Should it be extended to increase the force here? Maybe. It's possible we should try to, because then when it's further, when from there to there, basically, that's longer. The force will be stronger. So let's try to extend it a bit. If we even can, that's, yeah, that one. If I add 3 centimeters there, will that? That's an extreme, but it's interesting to try. Right now also, this looks like this will be a bit thin, but yeah, let's try that. I'm very interested in what, how that'll go. Yeah, you're unable to. Good old try until it fails. So 99 is okay, but not 1? Yeah, exactly. 1.1? No. Oh, 0.9999. There we go. Although, it might not be able to convert it to STL now, but let's try. Save. Bigger, longer, stronger. Save as STL. And let's just overwrite it. Yes. Then when we overwrite it, we can just tell Slicer to reload from disk. And then the new one's in here. Slice it. That should be okay. It takes 3 more minutes, but that's okay. That's because this is much bigger now. And now there's probably some infill here. Yeah, but not a lot, so that's okay. Let's have 100% infill. It's not a lot of, it's 13 grams of filaments. 13 grams of filament anyway. There's not, it doesn't cost a lot to make. And it's a good kind of test. So let's try. Export the G-code. Send it to Octoprint. Here's Octoprint, by the way. There we go. Pull it in here. And print. It'll start heating up. I'll need to put my build plate on again. Preferably without all the excess. There we go. And the build plate is in place, and let's see what Octoprint says. Working its way up. So let's the camera again. Should I can, and I can test the old one in our bathroom while the Prusa prints the new one. Let's see.
Thank you.
Thank you.